Good evening, students. In this session, we are going to see a new concept called how to identify a magnetic dipole in a current carrying closed loop. Normally, we know that in a bar magnet, where the north pole is there and where its south pole. So, we can identify the poles in a bar magnet and in some other magnets also, types of magnets, cylindrical magnets, U-shaped magnet, horseshoe magnet, like that. But suppose that and all not useful in higher level concept of magnetism. So for that we want to know a new rule called end rule to identify the poles which are induced due to a closed loop of current. Not open loop current, it is a closed loop. Closed loop means the loop should be closed. So it may be a square loop, it may be a circular loop, it may be a cylindrical loop, anything it may be. So for that we want to use a new rule called end rule, that is quite opposite to the right hand thumb rule. So you know that right hand thumb rule, pointing your right hand, the thumb pointing the direction of current, that is thumb is pointing the current direction, and you are curling fingers about the thumb which points the direction of magnetic field. But in the end rule, a slight adjustment is there, that is the reverse process. The thumb pointing the direction of magnetic field and your curling fingers points the direction of current. Suppose you consider a cylindrical core. It may be iron rod, or it may be iron pipe, anything it may be, or a plastic PVC pipe. So I am wounding a wire like this. So like this I am wounding the wire. And I am passing the current in this direction. For our convenience, I have inserted a rod inside this cylindrical coil. So it is a current carrying cylindrical coil. So it is a solenoid, we know that. And if it is without rod, I cannot be able to say the direction of current flow, because the coil seems to appear in both the direction. It will be a two-dimensional plane. Now, after inserting this rod, I can view this diagram in a three-dimensional view. Now, I can say this wire is moving inwards, behind this and coming outwards. So, the topmost layer of the wires are moving inwards. So, the current also moving inwards. So, at the top layer, current is, that is I moving inwards. I can write current moving inward. So I can put cross, because it is inward current. At the top, the current will be inward. So current is moving inward at every turn of the coil. Similarly, at the bottom, the current is moving outwards. Current is coming outward. Outward current will be there according to my end rule, my right hand end rule. So it will be outward current. So now you can easily understand. So inward current, how we considered outward magnetic field, inward symbolization is same, but here we are considering it as current instead of magnetic field. So the curling fingers represents the direction of current in end rule, and thumb points the direction of magnetic field. How we can determine the magnetic field? So that is very easy. Our thumb pointing direction is your north pole and this end is your south pole. I am moving my curling my fingers, so thumb is pointing towards the left side. So this is my north pole. Thumb pointing direction is your induced north pole, and the opposite end, this end, is your induced south pole. So in this way, I can identify the magnetic dipoles which is not already present in the region, which is induced due to the current carrying closed loop. Closed loop means, suppose it will be connected to a battery, then I can say current is flowing in this direction. So this is the direction of, this is the way to find the poles which is induced due to a current carrying closed loop. Suppose I am considering a rectangular loop, you consider like this. I can draw the axis for this, rectangular or square, it may be anything it may be. Now you can identify which line I can draw. This is A, B, C, D for your convenience. And the side AB is above the axis. Above the axis means this is my axis and side AB is here, and CD is behind the board like that. The loop will be like this. Square loop or rectangular loop. So current is flowing in this way, in this direction. So in this place, north pole will be induced, this side south pole, according to my end rule. This is not thumb rule, right hand end rule. So I can simply call it as end rule too. This is the rule which is used to identify the direction of magnetic field induced due to a closed current carrying loop. Any closed current carrying loop, it may be a circular loop, or it may be a rectangular loop, or it may be a square loop, anything it may be. So I can identify the direction of poles, and you know the magnetic field will be induced in this way. This we know. So field will be induced in this direction. inside this square or rectangular loop. So like this. So with the help of this idea, in the next session, we are going to talk about what happens when a current carrying loop is placed in a magnetic field. That is, when a magnetic dipole, simply a current carrying loop, a magnetic dipole is commonly called as closed current carrying loop. So magnetic dipole, this is not acting as a closed current loop. A closed current loop is a magnetic dipole. So in the next session, we are going to see how it will be responded. That is, a closed current carrying loop is responded when it is placed in an external uniform magnetic field. That is, torque experienced by a current carrying loop. That we will see in the next session. Thank you.